The good news for fintechs and IT giants is that, with payments, the modus operandi has been clear and accepted for the better part of the last century. Payment processors do not need to fret over draconian rules. Those are reserved for bank license holders. An analysis by McKinsey in 2017 revealed that the largest profit pools along the payments value chain are located at the endpoints, as this is where the end customer interface is. Why? Because it requires an extreme investment in brands and customer intimacy. Trust does not come cheap, and of course, customer interaction is riskiest. A concentrated group of B2B buyers might squeeze your margins, but is predictable. End customers and their dynamics are not. Data behemoths are right to occupy these endpoints, but why mobile wallets? Why not simply introduce payment features into the existing interfaces? Why isn't it enough to attach money to a Facebook conversation thread? Because to become really big, and of course this is what Silicon Valley wants, data collectors need to conquer the point of sale. Sending money via email or social networks would be a nice feature, but it is niche. Compare how often you transfer money to friends or family members to how often you pay for your groceries by card. Mobile payment is the perfect instrument to leverage IT giants' unparalleled databases. The only reason why the frenzy over mobile wallets had not erupted earlier was because the terminal infrastructure was still contact-based. With the advent of contactless technology, this infrastructure became irrelevant. You cannot squeeze a phone into a card terminal, but thanks to near-field communication, NFC technology, you don't have to. All it takes is a chip and an antenna. Whether it's glued to a piece of plastic, shored in a phone, or incorporated into a sticker, as was done by Austrian Erste Bank.